good everyone, welcome back to my channel. So I am upcycling a dress. This was my boyfriend's mom's dress and then it was too small on her, so she gave it to her daughter Sianda. White ba mandimenzele e v-neck like dress that goes below her knees. So this is it, that's the length. It's quite long. So I'm cutting the hem off here. So I didn't unpick it too much, so I left the hem that was pre-done, but now I'm cutting it. Yeah, well, the hem, because I don't have enough fabric to create straps. And the reason why it's so loose, kanje, like it's, she's obviously not this big. I just kept the, this fabric was like, it was sewn, it was a dress. It began, yeah, well, it was a square, and then I just cut the V and I obviously faced it so it has a nice finish. Yeah, well. Here, ganja. It's also gaping in front and gaping at the back. I want to add the strip that I'm cutting on the hem, so we'll pretend this is it. I want to put it like inside and then it comes from, it comes out upper, it goes around the shoulder and it hits here at back. And then what Usiana can do is like scrunch it, so just pull it and this part will like scrunch up and create like nice gathers, and it's gonna sit like that, and then it'll give an illusion of like fullness or like pleats or like gathers. Yeah, well, and it's not gonna be like one long material, it's gonna come ganja nicely and then sit like that. Yeah, well. So I hope that works out to my benefit. Someone's coming through, so I need to go and open the door, and then once I'm done cutting this, I'll probably take another shot when I'm inserting this strap inside here. Can you hear the knock? Now they're attempting to open the door.
Yeah.
Pieces that broke, and I'm watching Resident Evil. I'm done attaching all the pieces that ripped, so I'm just gonna iron these points open because I want to use my overlocker to overlock the edges. They won't be visible, but it'll kind of cut away parts like this that might potentially fray, because the end goal is for me to fold this three times like that, that, and then inside itself. But I don't want to have like large pieces like sticking out like that. It's an unnecessary step, but I love it. I just finished ironing the seams open and I realized that overlocking this is actually going to be a waste of time, so I'll just do a four-step iron, which I'll show you. Okay, so step one is to iron this flat, right? Just iron. I'm using this corner because it's the only way I can get this frame. This is my sewing stand where the threads go. Then, so that was step one of ironing, and then this is step two, which is ironing it in half. I'm doing a spaghetti strap, but I don't want to sew, like turn it inside out and sew like that, because I won't be able to pull through. I won't be able to turn the right side, which is this one, outside again. I think only people that know how to sew will get what I'm trying to say here with right sides and wrong sides and turning things inside out. This is tedious work, but I think once I'm done, it'll look great. It'll be worth it. And I love ironing to the point that I actually want to... I've already created a playlist. Like, I want to start a series where on YouTube where I follow existing tutorials, but then I add an iron. So this is like my guest, like my special trick or feature. But obviously it'll only work once I find tutorials from people, usually like upcoming designers or like DIY or upcyclers, who tend to follow also tutorials or create their own tutorials, but then they never iron their things. And if you don't iron your garments, they really look like they were made by someone. Like, all garments are obviously made by people, but like, if you don't like iron your seams after every time you sew, then it gives off the it literally gives off like it was a project that was made at home. But if you feature an iron, then it adds on to like the newness and like technicality of making clothes, especially in the sewing process. So anyway, yeah, I want to start a series where I follow tutorials and then I just feature an iron and I show people like the difference between the that person's, that creator's tutorial compared to mine once I've featured an iron. Just to show like a small thing as an iron can give your product very nice visual presentation, a visual, I want to say aesthetic, but this word doesn't really fit in the conversation. Okay, so this is step three, which is, it's actually a three step, but I said four step because I was going to iron one side all the way down, then come back and iron this other side. So it would be four steps, but we'll combine step three and four and just fold them. Ganj. Okay, so this is step three, and then, okay, I'm right. This is step three. Then step four would be that, and then I'll sew it like that, and then I'll get my spaghetti strap. Okay, so back to the misuse of aesthetic. So I want to feature this iron just to show people the difference an iron can make and how that will add more value to your final product, especially to people that are sewing projects or following tutorials with the hopes of selling their work. An iron is very, very important because, again, it'll give... the word I want to use is actually hanger appeal, but hanger appeal applies to when clothes are hanged. So there's a way that you, when you make something, especially if it's for retail and it goes in store, a person needs to figure out like how to present the garment and how to hang it and kind of like which hanger to use so that the garment looks good while it's hung. Ooh. The steam is burning me, right? So that's hanger appeal. So that's what I'm trying to do, like, but I don't know what to call it. We can call it the iron appeal. That a garment looks way better when it's ironed, like, and then you don't iron it at the end. That's another problem I think people do. If you iron it at the end, it's very hard to iron a finished product. It's hard to make seams nice and flat when a garment is already like done. So even in university, like the sewing teachers in the sewing lab would always encourage you to sew and iron, stitch, make a stitch and go iron it flat, make a stitch, go iron it flat. Because the minute you close, like let's say you close off your leg, it'll be hard to press open the side seam because now the legs are two circular shapes that are closed off, right? So now it's hard to go up, like iron the leg, especially if you're ironing it from inside. Whereas while it's still open, while it's not like fully complete, you can iron each section or each part. And yeah, that was my iron tape talk. Yeah, I'm excited for the series, but I still need to look for videos of creators that have made projects and did not feature an iron. And this was actually, it happened quite a lot. I think between the year 2018, 2019, where people would be so excited to share their tutorials and like share videos of themselves following other people's tutorials. And obviously like they're doing it from home. So they would just sew everything and never really iron their stuff. Yeah, well, which would create like bulky items that look very much DIY. So yeah, and also even like it, and then this was very prominent within the American creators, like American YouTubers or YouTubers from overseas. They also like making tutorials without overlocking their garments, and I do understand like an overlocker is quite expensive, but there are other like stitches a person can do to like finish their garments, so that when the upcycling is great and making your own clothes is great, but then sometimes I question that, because if you sew a garment and then it's not finished in a way that will protect its longevity, then you'll end up wearing it one or two times, because the minute you wash it, it might fall apart. Yeah, well, so even if a person doesn't have an overlocker, and there's tutorials they don't overlock because they have a straight stitch machine, there are ways you can sew a garment that will protect the edges, like this, like these edges are not protected, they're not overlocked. So a person would literally sew a hem, make a stitch there, just because it's in the inside and no one can see it, they'll be like, oh, it's inside, no one will see it, so it's fine. But then the minute you wash this, it does that. So you can wear this, you would wear your top from your tutorial maybe 1 to 10 times, and then it would literally start breaking. So you need to protect this. So if this was the hem, you would literally iron it like this and then iron it up again and then stitch, that way there's no raw edge, right? And there's a thing called French seams, where if you don't have an overlocker, you can do French seams on the inside of your garments, and then that leads to also longevity. So that's why I really want to start like the new series where I feature an iron, and I can also like, if I come across these videos that I'm talking about, I know them from memory, but I don't have the tutorials anymore, then I could like make the same garments those people are making and just add these technical points to them, right? There's really nothing wrong with learning how to sew online, but then some tutorials don't give like full information, and I think those people are also making because they follow other tutorials, and there's nothing wrong with that. So yeah, that is my final TED talk and ironing session. And also, I'm not gonna fast forward this video, obviously, because I'm speaking, but I just wanted to illustrate how long it takes to iron certain things, like how long production takes. This is how many minutes now? This is 9 minutes, and I still have like a lot more to iron. So sewing will dribble you. Sewing, you literally, someone would be like, yo, can you make, for instance, this dress, even, let me use this example as a dress. I thought this was going to take me a day. I started this dress yesterday and I'm still not done. So yeah, some pieces would look very simple to make, because this is the illustration. Like when I illustrated this dress, literally that, I was like, ah, this is going to take me half a day. but now making the straps for it is literally almost 20 minutes long. Okay, I'll stop talking now, and then this is my cue to fast forward the video. Okay, I had to take a young nap because my camera is quite foggy. This is the front camera. Maybe I need to change my screen protector because it's going to protect some goes over my front camera. So that's why it's foggy. But yeah, I took a nap because I have a stomach bug, but I'm back now because there might be load shedding at 2 p.m. and it's currently 1 p.m. I finished sewing the spaghetti straps, and this is how they look. And I already marked holes in the points where I want the strap to go through. But in the end, you gotta figure this out is how everything will kind of function, because I want the strap to go like that, and then I don't know. Okay, let me get a safety pin. Safety pin. I hate these safety pins because they're quite weak. But I do need a small one because the holes I made are quite small. Or Resident Evil. I've been on a Resident Evil marathon for the past 2 or 3 days during load shedding. Then I watch Resident Evil. I go mind like a movie series because now I can follow it because I don't have to wait 2-3 years to watch the next movie, and then by then I didn't understand what was going on. Resident Evil. I hope I'm in frame because I can't see what I'm like, what's recording. My phone also died during that ironing session, just to show you how long it took for me to iron. Okay, so this one is through. Okay, and then let me add a pin up so that things don't move around. So I'm just pinning it inside so that the strap and its faggy layer doesn't fall down. So now the strap is going from the front to the back. Then I marked a hole here, but now I would have to put this one up, honey. I have no idea how to do this. Okay, let's see. Let me put like, I don't know how to do it. So this is the vision group, right? So this goes like that. Yeah. There's 4 exits. Let's see. Okay, so there's this now. Maybe I should put this in the hole I made. Let's put it in the hole I made at the back. Okay, so this is one side. Me and this side, okay, I think I got it. I'm gonna hold on to this, and this one I'm gonna put through the other pointy part. So now we have a strap that comes out this point and goes in the back. Then we do the same thing. The side comes out the pointy and goes to the back. But now we have a problem, because now how do, this one needs to go to the back. What if, okay, let's take this which was at the back and then put it on the other back. Like the front, this section is nice, and the back as well is nice, like you can put it. But the side that's not cooperating is the sides. Like, I don't know how, what I should do to, so that a person can be able to pull from here to there. Yeah, well. This is like the back. You can pull it nicely. It's just that I've pinned it just to give you like the illusion that it's stretched. But this is now my biggest concern, like this gap here is just gonna be like that. I don't know, I don't feel like this dress is giving what it's meant to give. Obviously it's super long, but yeah, the back is a mess, but it's meant to like come up like that. Is this even, yeah, this is the front. Oh Jesus, nah, this is not it. And I'm even scared of sewing it, because if I sew it then and it doesn't look nice, then I'll have to like unpick it. Okay, let me sew it down so that it visually looks much better and I can actually see what's going on, because I'm a bit lost myself and I'm making the dress. Let's sew it and see. I'm gonna sew it off camera because I feel under pressure and my mind is not working properly. So yeah, let's go. But okay, body suit. I said bodacia, but okay. Here's the dress. I don't like it. And I'm really tired. So the idea is to tala here. And I feel like I'm tala because I've sewn some of the string. So like accidentally sewed it, so now it doesn't move, it's stuck. I love you. So now I have to start over. That's it. Thanks for watching. Bye. That's the end of the video. Things don't really work out how you plan them. And I literally spent my entire day on this. 2 days, yesterday and today, but again. It's fine. There's still enough fabric because when I wore it, it was quite long. So I can. Let's do it now. Let me cut it now because I'll put it away and I'll never touch it again. So let me just fix it now. So I'm cutting it. Cutting it up. Let's see if I can get out of this. Just cut it. also what I didn't do is I didn't make a pattern for this dress. I just took an existing pattern and then I just figured some things mentally, and this was that, a combination of a DIY pattern and some enthusiasm. So all right, so we have two pieces of fabric. This was the side and this is the other side. So I'm just gonna do it as I was meant to do it, which was this basically. V with the string and the string tight there, nothing big, no gathers, nothing that I made, and there's still enough fabric, you know? So it's not a train smash. I'm gonna end the video here because didiniwe, and nothing is really gonna work out if I don't take a break and just recuperate. I'm just happy I'm not beating myself galendo, because if this was me last year, I would literally chuck this and dimbale kumduwayo. But I'm actually motivated to really like fix this and do it properly dimnike, because ndihleli phezu kweqhinga. It's not really a qhinga, but there's something I want to do and see if it works. There's an experiment I'm conducting, and that's why I accepted to do this project for my sister's boyfriend. So there's definitely going to be a part two on this. I'm not really going to show the sewing process much, but I'll give in on the secret as to why I'm doing this and what the experiment is on part two. So that's it for today. Thank you so much for watching. Again, if you want to see more of, not necessarily me, but my work, you can find that on Facebook, being Anita Hlazo, on Instagram, I'm Anita Hlazo with an underscore at the end, because there's quite a few Anita Hlazos on IG. Oh, and on Facebook, I have green braids. My wallpaper is a ghost, green and black twists, rather not braids. For my design work, I am at Afro Grunge, and this work I'll put under a page called African Flair, where I work with African print, and hopefully I'll open myself to working with one-on-one clients. Like this, I would consider like a one-of-one, because I'm custom making it for Osteanda, you know. So this, hopefully she's cool with me taking pictures of her, or Ganye, and when she has pictures she can submit them to me, and then I'll post them on my socials. But anyway, yeah, that's it. Thank you so much for watching. Bye to editing. I'm gonna also eat mbani kange amge one. So I'm gonna have lunch. Okay, that's also my cue to end the video. Bye.